Slab leak repair. Everything you need to know to not get jacked over. You really need to know three things about a slab leak repair, and I'm gonna tell you exactly what they are to help you save money and make your repairs last longer.
Here we go!
But first, I'm gonna ask you to subscribe and share this video with anybody that you know that maybe has had slab leak problems, is having slab leak problems, or owns a home. This is information everybody that owns a home really needs to know. A lot of plumbers say that they can find slab leaks with cameras. And to be honest, if there's a big slab leak, yes, they can. If there's roots, if there's a break, if there's anything major, getting in there and finding that particular one is very easy to do. But sometimes we just find a crack on a fitting, maybe a piece of pipe where it's been pulled out, doesn't show a whole lot of daylight or anything, and you may be able to see some things like that on a camera, but normally you need to do a sewer water test and an isolation test. So the very first thing that you need to know is exactly where that leak is and how do they find that? Well, what a good plumbing company does is isolate the area. You can push test balls in to different areas of the system, fill it up, and see if that area holds water or if it leaks down. And also, how fast does it leak down? That can help determine the size of the leak. If it leaks down really fast, you've probably got a major break there. If it's slow, it could be just a little bitty crack. There could be a hole in the pipe, depending on what type pipe it is. It could be a lot of different things. But you wanna make sure that you know, that your plumbing company knows exactly where the leak is. Now, one other quick thing right here, don't let a plumbing company come in and tell you, look, you just need to replace everything. I literally have only done that one time in 41 years of plumbing have we ever had to replace everything under a house. And I'm not saying it doesn't happen often, but one time in 40 years, it doesn't happen that often. So if your plumbing company is walking in saying you have leaks, you just need to replace everything, definitely get a second opinion. Think about it like this. If you've got a break and you go to the doctor just doesn't put a cast on anywhere. He knows exactly what he's going in to fix and exactly what he's going in to do. So you or your plumbing company should be able to prove to you exactly where the leaks are and why. Now I'm gonna tell you here, stay till the end because I'm gonna give you the biggest tip and the biggest thing you need to know that's gonna save you money even longer just by knowing this one little detail. So tip number two, use the best materials. Now you as a homeowner may not know the best materials. You as a homeowner may think, hey, any material they fix it with is good. That is not always true. And replacing pipe with exactly what's there is not always the best thing to do. When we go in and make repairs now on a cast iron system, we'll actually replace that with PVC pipe in a residential type environment. If it's just normal residential plumbing, we can take the rotten cast iron pipe out and put in new PVC pipe that's rated to last a lot longer. So this is actually gonna help your system survive longer and do better, and you're not gonna have any problems with that. Now, you could still have problems on the other cast iron pipe later, and if the walls look real thin, I may suggest to a customer that we go ahead and replace a little bit more than just what's leaking. So either way we go about it, I wanna make sure the customer is informed, they know what's happening, and I give them options. Because actually, it's up to them what all we fix, or what all we end up doing. Another big thing on this is the rods, the hangers, the things that they're using. Don't just use something plated. We prefer to use stainless steel. It will last longer underground. So we wanna make sure that whatever product we put in, now remember again, I'm talking about the hangers to hold the cast iron pipe, the PVC pipe, whatever is in there, we have supported other pipe before to keep it from moving around. So we wanna make sure that if we put in rod, if we put in nuts, washers, hangers, stuff like that, we use stainless steel so it will last longer. So using the right thing is really a big deal. Think about if you went to a bar and you ordered a margarita. Redneck margarita machine. Really? Built by a plumber. And they put whiskey in it instead of tequila. Well, you may still get a buzz, but it may not really be that good. Point number three, and this is a big one. Test, test, test. We don't just run a camera to find out where it is. We come in and do tests to locate it. Now, you can almost always tell where an area is leaking, but it is possible that you have a leak in a certain spot that won't allow you to test other things. If we've got a leak at the two-way cleanout, or maybe there's not a two-way cleanout, there's a single cleanout there, we would really rather have a two-way cleanout to make it where we can test it accurately and see if any water's running out. So testing is a big deal. You not only want to test then and test the different areas to determine what's leaking or what's not leaking, but the big thing about it is you want to keep doing tests all the way through the process, meaning after they make the repair, test it. Okay, now they know everything's good. They do the same initial test to determine there are no leaks under the house. Now, one thing I like to do is leave this test on while it's being backfilled. That way, when people are getting out of the tunnel, they can actually look down and say, look, everything is still holding. We actually had a problem out in Saxe one time. We did a sewer repair under a house. The dig crew came back in, packed everything in, and pulled something loose. They didn't tell us. So whenever we went back out there later, the customer was still having problems. We ran a camera in the line and saw that something had pulled apart. So now we are really bad about testing everything multiple times. If you do this, it's gonna help make sure that when they're done and walk away, they don't have a leak and you don't have a problem that's still gonna haunt you later. If they tie in a certain area, if they make one repair, and I say they, if it's they, if you're a homeowner, you, if you're a plumber, when you tie in one area, test it. Test that system. Is everything holding like it's supposed to? Some people do, some people don't. Some people just throw it in and say, look, it's fixed, I'm out of here. Test and double test. Test it multiple times to make sure you don't have a problem. Now, number four, this is the big tip or trick that I told you about that I'm gonna tell you that is one of the most important things. Whether you're a homeowner or a plumber, make sure you pull a permit, you get it inspected, you test it again. The reason being, this is gonna help keep you out of trouble. If you're a plumbing company and the homeowner gets mad, says something didn't get right, you can at least come back and say, look, we permitted it, we inspected it, the city looked at it, we did everything right per code. If you don't do this and they come back, you can be held responsible for anything that they say is wrong or the other plumber that comes in is wrong. You as a homeowner, always make sure you talk to your plumbers. Are you pulling a permit? Are you getting this inspected? Is everything being done right? That little thing done by whoever comes out and works on your system is gonna make all the difference in the world. You now have peace of mind. And one other little tip, something we do, if we tunnel under a house to do a sewer or water repair, we call an engineer company and have them do a structural engineer's report. We want to make sure our tunnel does not cause any problems for the house anytime in the future. I hope that helps you out. I'm Roger Wakefield, Lead AP, the expert plumber. I'll see you in the next video if you don't get flushed.